Hey folks, Captain Dave here. Welcome to the Wolf Den. Look at this mess. Well, it's blowing outside. It's been raining. It's the day before Thanksgiving, and I'm pretty bored. So what I did is I pulled a box out of the boat. My only box of hard baits, hard lures. And I just decided I'm going to look over some of the hooks. Because if they sit there and they got some crap hooks on them or whatever, when I go to pull these out, put them on, I don't want any surprises. So what I got here is the only hard baits that I use. I'm real particular. I'm not 100% lure fisherman, but what I do is I want to fish certain baits and I want to catch certain species. Okay. Now I just changed from treble hooks on this monster Larry Dahlberg River to Sea Wide Glide. This thing is so kick ass. Now, if I could only catch a fish on it. I went from what they give you, which is these trebles. They're huge trebles, sharp trebles. And I went and put on these double hooks, okay, with no split rings, no nothing, because they're not needed. And the reason being is because this is a glide bait. It'll run just under the surface, right on the surface. I mean, you can make this do a lot of different things. That is the killer deal about this bait right here. It kicks like a searching mullet, okay? Larry Dahlberg and the Muskie Boys would tell you something different. This is a mullet to me. And what I did is I put these hooks on because really next summer, I wanna probably pull up right behind a shrimp boat. And I want to hook me one of them big, bad black tips or something on one of these. Or I'm going to toss it over a reef, anchor up on a reef, and I want to get big cudas or maybe a king mackerel or something on it. Who knows? So I did that. And I'm going to do the same thing with this. This is a Salmo Made in Poland vibrator bait. It vibrates through the water. It's pretty heavy, but at the same time, it's not straight to the bottom, you know, heavy. It has some buoyancy type thing to it, where it sinks, but it kind of wiggles down. Well, what I'm going to do is I want to take off these treble hooks and these split rings, and I'm going to take these double hooks and put them on, just like I just did on the Wide Glide. It's a crappy day. It's been a crappy day all day. I've been bored. So I figured I'd pull my only lure box out of the boat and do some hook changing. And just to look at what I got here. And if there's a tech tip, that's it. Take a crappy day, get in your boat, make it lean, make it right. I purposely don't carry a ton of crapola in my boat. I carry what I need to get the job done. And maybe that's the reason why I don't own a walk-around cabin boat. Okay. I've gone and looked in these walk-around cabin boats. And you open it up, and it's, you know, 950 degrees down there in the summertime. And that thing has got so much junk in it. That's just not me. I like lean, lean, lean. And have just what I need to get the job done. I got these in there. This is, I don't know if you saw from another video that I did. I threw this for an hour and a half. The Storm Kick and Stick 20. Threw that for an hour and a half in the river. And a 19-inch, 21-inch trout engulfed this thing. So, in all reality, don't be afraid to use big baits to target bigger fish. I really wanted that to be an 8, 10 pound trout. But So I'm just looking over everything that I got here. There's the number one lure for me of all time. It's the mini version of this. This is the Wide Glide Floater. Larry Dahlberg River Sea Wide Glide Floater. This, if I can't catch them on this, there's only one other thing that I'm usually going to. And that's the Kick-A Mullet. Okay, you've seen me talk about this on other videos, the Kick-A Mullet. This takes some skill to run. You got to know how to work it. This, no skill required. I've taken two gals this summer who didn't know anything about fishing. One asked me, what are we going to do today? I said, we're going to throw lures. And she goes, what's a lure? Well, guess what? Her first fish was 25-inch trout. We take these, cast this out as absolutely far as you possibly can over the spot that we're at. Let it hit the water. One potato, two potato, three potatoes start reeling nice and slow. And the Kick-A Mullet, this wedge tail, that's what they call the wedge tail, with a little ball in it, has a slight rattle, and this thing will run right across the surface, throwing a little V wake, and it gets blasted by fish. Okay, nice big trout, that looks like a mullet, running along the top of the water. This looks like a searching mullet. I can make this go, and then let it sink a little bit, and then searching mullet. He's kind of searching. Or then I can do what I call just a kind of a little silent slap. It could be the top of the water, and I can take this and do a little walk the dog with it. Just to get this to go. You know, very much, very similar. I can make it do very similar to what you do on a walk the dog lure, you know, a mirror lure or anything like that. But I got lots of redundancy here. This whole front is nothing but Kick-A mullets. Okay. This is another color. Over in Mississippi, Louisiana, and places like that, it's very popular to fish chartreuse tail, soft plastics. I tried this one because I'm thinking trout looking up, this black bait, you know, with the sun just coming up, might show up a little better. And then you got the little brightness of the tail, so I tried getting those colors. Here's another lure. I don't know if I've ever shown too much of it. This is the miniature Larry Dahlberg River to Sea Whopper Plopper. And what it is, it's kind of like a prop bait. See how that spins around? Okay. But here's the difference too, is it's real soft. Okay. Now, the musky fishermen, you know, they cast this thing out and go blah, 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 makes all kinds of noise. I've never caught a single fish doing that, except maybe a ladyfish or something. What I do is this sits in the water like that, with just the nose sticking up. And what I do is I pop it up, go plop, 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 bring it up, plop, 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 and then might, you know, twitch it around a little bit and just get this to kind of just splash. Looks like a fish just kicking his tail like a wounded mullet. It's got that nice round profile. The big eyes, looks like a mullet to me. And of course, it's got all kinds of rattles in it. So what I'm really doing is I'm going to take the salmo. The two lures that I really want to get up behind shrimp boats or something. Or while chum fishing or whatever. And I really want to get some sharks on. I'd really like to start catching some sharks on some lures just for the hell of it. Okay. But this is the one thing you can do is pull some stuff out of your boat. And now that we've got the time, you've got some bad weather, and go over what you got. That's what I'm doing. Just checking things out. I got a good pair of split ring pliers here, braid split ring pliers. It's almost a necessity for changing out. You've got to have a good set of split ring pliers to get in here and open that up so you can take these trebles off. Okay. A little cheapy pair isn't worth a hoot. You really want to get a decent pair here. And so that's pretty much the tech tip. I figured I'd throw something out here, show you a couple lures. Yep, and here's what it goes with on trout. Yes, I have failed to catch a fish on this monster here. But see the size of that? I don't understand why I can't get a big trout on this one. Not necessarily this one, but this is lighter one. This one's a little lighter version with the treble hooks. And I caught him on this. I want to catch him on this one. I try this one. I can't get him to eat this one. I pulled mullet out of trout's mouth. That the mullet was stuck on a 5-pound trout. Stuck in his throat and nothing but the tail sticking out of his mouth. And I still caught him on a 3-inch shrimp. So I know big trout will eat this. Because if a 21-inch trout had this down in its mouth this last summer, I know they'll eat that one. So that's the challenge of lures. I don't fish lures because I'm going out to you know, whack them and stack them. I know what will whack them and stack them. Soft plastics in the summer on a jig head, in the spring, fall, you know, wintertime, float rig, live shrimp. I know that'll whack them and stack them. But I always fish lures just for the pure challenge of it. And many times in the summer because we can't use any bait. There's just too many bait sealers around here. So that's just a little tech tip. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the water. See you out there at the Mayport Jetties.